This first match for New Year's Bash is scheduled for one fall. It is a tag team match. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 320 pounds, here is the team of the High Flying Chet Okuma and Terrence Knight Ontario, Team KO! At a total combined weight of 445 pounds, please welcome the team of Ahuna and the pioneer of Hawaiian strong style, Kaneala!
Oh, and from behind, here comes Ahuna knocking down Chet Okuma to start off the match. And we welcome you for the first time tonight to New Year's Bash 2011. Felipe Ojasco along with Dangerous Daryl Bonilla, DDB. And we have four men in the ring here, DDB, with a whole lot of hatred and history with each other.
Oh, yeah, talk about a bash. I mean, it's not going to get any more interesting than Chet Okuma. He's got his issues with Kaneala, that's well documented. And the new rivalry between the newcomer, TKO, and Ahuna.
So certainly a tilt to our head scissors there by Chet Okuma, and it was at Battle Clash over in Waipahu a month ago where TKO got a victory over Ahuna, shook his hand after the match, gave him a short arm clothesline, and Ahuna laid him out with a Hawaiian war club.
Crazy, look at that. For a team that never teamed together, I mean, nice double dropkick to start things off here. Pretty impressive here with Chet Okuma and TKO, and you can see the fans appreciate it.
And certainly it's a lot of chemistry here between Ahuna and Kaneala, because a while back, a long time ago, this is their first time teaming together in over 5 years.
Yeah, and a promotion far, far away. They were once called the Night Marchers, and for one night only, we get a little reunion here of the Night Marchers. And for anybody who knew the Night Marchers, you know, they were known for their finesse. They were known about just stomping people's heads in.
Oh, what a cheap shot there by Ahuna as he sends Okuma for the ride. Okuma floats over, off the ropes, ducks the clothesline, ducks another one. Here comes Okuma with a flying forearm shot. And a drop kick right to the knee. And here comes Okuma again, but Ahuna able to calculate that and give him a shoulder block of his own.
A little bit of a power taking over a little bit on the speed there.
Well, Okuma with a nice reversal, ducking out of the way. Oh, man.
That was a nice kick.
Vicious Muay Thai kicks.
Right in the guts.
And one to the back for good measure. And another.
Things are not looking good for the Night Marchers.
Oh, certainly not. So here comes Ahuna, coming off an injury that he suffered a couple months ago. He's still feeling the effects of it in his left leg as the first tag of the match comes to Ontario. Here comes a double team move. TKO, inverted atomic drop. And oh, one man in Zaguri. First cover.
I gotta say, I'm a little impressed here with the teamwork of TKO and Chet Okuma. I mean, they're really taking it to the Night Marchers. I mean, this is a little bit different. You would think that the Night Marchers would be the one going at it, but, you know, TKO and Chet Okuma not letting him up.
And certainly TKO, one of the breakout stars for AZW in 2010, and showing off why. A couple of shots to the side of the head. He'll send Ahuna for the ride.
Oh! Was that like a Southern Savant kick?
Cover! And Kaniala heads a play to make the save.
Oh, that was right on the button. That was right in the mush.
Man. So again, as we mentioned before, four men with a whole lot of history. Between Kaniala and this man right here, Jet Akuma, on the right side of your screen.
I gotta say, if this is how we're starting 2011, man, I'm excited for AZW this year.
Double shoulder block. Couldn't have said it better right there, DDB. And another cover here from Jet, and gets a two count.
You can see it, like Akuma, he's still kind of, you can see he's favoring that back a little bit. You don't know if he's 100% just quite yet. I mean, you don't recover for an injury like that and then take the kind of bumps and the kind of punishment in the ring and be 100%. So you don't know, you know.
And Kaniala has gone on the record saying that he will, given the opportunity, give another muscle buster to Jet Akuma and sideline him for six more months or maybe permanently. Here comes a Ahuna and a clothesline right on the button.
That was reminiscent of the clothesline I gave Kenjiro back in HCW versus AZW. And for those who know, you know what I'm talking about.
As Kaniala comes in to make another save. And a vicious chop.
Kaniala trying to get the momentum back here for he and Ahuna here. But generally speaking, in general, I mean, Kaniala is known as the pioneer of Hawaiian strong style. So generally speaking, I mean, he's going to bring it in general.
And he's not a happy camper after losing to Akuma at Battle Clash. And again, that another Muay Thai kick to the upper back. And another one. And one more to the back of the head. TKO really feeling the pain right now. It's a blatant rake to the eye. And referee Arthur Pinpin trying to break it up.
And I'm glad to see Arthur Pinpin back in action. We all saw what happened at Battle Clash. And for those who didn't, it was courtesy of the DVD. You can see he took a vicious kendo-stalk to the side of the head from Kenjiro. But he's back in action and looking in shape. But he's got his hands full right now with this match.
Trading blows now. Ontario with a right hand. And another. And a third one. And Kaniala ends all argument with a lariat of his own.
Call that the momentum killer.
Especially when TKO is trying to build some momentum for his team. Kaniala just pulls the plug on the party. Here comes the pioneer of Hawaiian strong style. Hit! Straight to the face of TKO. Oh! And a low blow right in front of the ref. And there's the open opportunity that TKO and Akuma needed.
Akuma, what he might lack in size, the kid doesn't lack in heart, man. That kid's got a ton of heart, and he brings it every time out. I mean, rain or shine, he'll go. I mean, not too much people go toe-to-toe with Kaniala and live to talk about it, you know?
Kaniala gets his hand on the ropes, and certainly right about that. I'm interested to see what Kaniala has in store for Akuma here at New Year's Bash.
You know he's going to target that back any chance he gets. You know it's going to happen eventually. The minute he gets an opportunity, he's going to take advantage of it.
Face first into the buckle goes Kaniala, and three kicks to the back.
And he did that without wires.
Second row BME, lands on his feet, ducks the kick, does Akuma. Crescent kick, no good.
Oh, you can see right there, right to the back. That kind of be good.
Sky high Samoan drop.
Oh, he got some frequent flyer miles on that one.
Man. And both men are down. But Kaniala has the advantage. He's right next to Ahuna. He makes a tag, and here comes Ahuna. Akuma's back up, and
smart.
He's got a hot tag. Fresh legs in there.
Another knockdown. Oh, man, he's got that southern fire in him.
From Atlanta, Georgia.
He's getting down and dirty.
Big knee right to the chest. Cover.
Well, more like the belly button. He kind of got the belly button on that one.
Didn't get enough height on that one.
Yeah, but got enough.
And a suplex, and what power by TKO, taking over 240.
We got quite the crowd here, too. Quite the crowd here enjoying AZW action here. It's going to be standing room only before you know it.
Action Zone Wrestling back here on Olelo Felipe inside the Action Zone, the Tiger Muay Thai Gym in Aiea. And I want to make sure that you mark down March 12th. It is AZW's next event, March to Madness, as we determine through a tournament the number one contender for Mr. Athletics AZW Heavyweight Championship. And right now, joining me is one of the creepiest guys I've ever seen in any organization. Here's Dementia.
Finally, I get my shot coming this March. Dementia, World Heavyweight Champion.
I can't see it. Pence, it's blind.
Oh, and a big knee right to the side of the face. And a big splash from Ohuna.
And it's great to see Arthur Pimpin not counting at this time.
What referee school did he go to?
You know Richard Hamasaki would be counting right now.
I'll tell you why, I wouldn't want to mess with Richard Hamasaki, tell you that. Oh, and a big boot right to the side of the head. Kaneala, those vicious kicks. I know we're in the Tiger Muay Thai gym, and he's showing off those Tiger Muay Thai kicks. Oh. Setting him up for the muscle buster. Trying to hang on. He's got him up. Akuma makes the save. Double suplex. Bam, right on the money.
Nice teamwork there. Got the big guy up, you know, takes a lot of strength. So you can see the effect still on Akuma there, favoring the back a little bit, but they just got enough to get him over.
Again, over 240 pounds.
Jet Akuma?
No.
Oh.
It is Kaneala, and took 2 men to take him over. You can see the fatigue setting in now for TKO.
Yeah, this is quite the pace they're putting up right now. You know, they're not even taking any chances, no breathers here. They're going full tilt, 120% right now.
And the fatigue, and look at that. As TKO to the floor. No, there's no padding here, folks. It's just solid concrete. But in the meantime, Akuma is taking his hands at Ohuna. And Ohuna landing some elbows.
Oh, hell's breaking loose over here.
And for the ride, big kick off the duck under and a kick to the midsection. I tell you what, Akuma better watch out.
Yeah, he's got to turn around here.
Going for the code red, but he hooked him in.
Oh, no. Oh,
right in the back. Bam, blood driver.
Oh, Akuma's out. Tiki's all by himself now.
Being sandwiched in between. Yeah. Wait for the money maker.
It's like a modified version of it, almost like a neck breaker.
Ohuna gonna try and clean up the mess. There it is, the Tilt-A-Whirl slam. And he got it.
What a match.
Your winner of the match, the team of Ohuna and Kaneala.
AZW back here on Olelo. Felipe Ojastro inside the action zone as we are getting set for March 12th. It is March to Madness right here at the Tiger Muay Thai Gym in IA. A big time tournament as we determine the number one contender for Mr. Athletics AZW Heavyweight Championship. And right now joining me is one of the most dangerous men to ever step foot in an AZW ring. He'll be in the tournament, but will the gold be around your waist, Ohuna?
First of all, let's get back to your demeanor. I mean, show some life, man. I mean, your introductions suck. You suck. I mean, Felipe, you can get more lively when you introduce people, but I guess that's just not your style, right? I mean, look at you. Talking's regular. Is he gonna wear the gold? That's a stupid question to be asking. First of all, let's just go back to, how come you're not asking me questions about when I win? You know, the last show we won, right? Last show, you said I sucker punched someone. And then you question me. People are asking you, oh, how come you did that, Ohuna? Why? Where's that tone of voice from you now? We pick up the win and you don't ask stupid questions like that now, huh? That's okay. Stupid people say stupid things, right? Say it. Say you're a stupid person.
I'm not going to say that.
Why?
I'm not.
Okay, never mind. Since you don't like saying nothing. March to Madness, March 12th is the date. Jeff Cobb, everybody's going to be entering a tournament to make a run at your heavyweight title. Good win you got. Sorry for everybody in AZW because Ohuna will win the tournament. And when I do, you will find out just how dangerous I am, just how dangerous I can be. And to answer your question about the gold being around my waist, I can pretty much say, yeah, I'll be wearing the gold. What do you think?
We'll find out March 12th. It's March to Madness. Blade right to the face. And again, outside.
Oh, this is not going to be good. Dementia was out here last time, and he got quite close to the wall.
Oh, no, 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 no. Stop it. Get that chair out of that guy's hand. Oh, man. He missed. Kenjiro goes down. Did you hear that shot? Oh, and a big boot. Dementia. Dragging the body of Kenjiro back in the ring. Can he take advantage of it? He's going to inflict more punishment now. Here comes Dementia. Man. Both feet right to the kisser of Kenjiro.
Oh, I got to say, I'm impressed with what Dementia is showing me tonight. I mean, I don't know if Dementia has a family, but if he does, his daddy must be proud.
And another knee right to the side of the head.
I don't want to like gloat on the fact that Oki and Kenjiro are like hitting like bad luck left and right, but I love it.
You must be. And you're a richer man.
Oh, nice Michinoku driver there by Dementia. And he wasn't picking up a lightweight.
240 pounds. Can he make the cover? No, he's still not going to make the cover. There's Dementia.
What's he going to do now?
He's going to head to the top.
There we go. Fans definitely behind Dementia here. Making a statement here in the solo ranks. Trying to be a singles competitor. This could be his moment. Oh, and a swanton.
Will that be enough? Here's the cover.
Yeah, beautiful.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the match, Dementia.
Dementia does not look happy. He actually might like the pain. Felipe here inside the Action Zone. Well, there you have it. Thanks for joining us for another great edition of Action Zone Wrestling here on Olelo. And right now, it's unpleasant surprise from Kenjiro.
Oh, you shut up, my son! Huh? Everybody say, want the title, beat the Jeff Cobb. Kenjiro, don't care about title! Jeff Cobb, I put you out wrestling. You want out. I end your career. Poison. Mark my words. DDB, I will get you for your treachery. But first, we take out your Jeffy Cobb. Baka.
It's going to be one hell of an event. The Tiger Muay Thai Gym in IAEA, March 12th. It is March to Madness.
Scheduled for one fall, and it is for the AZW Tag Team Titles. Introducing first. From the Polynesian Circle, weighing in at a combined weight of 490 pounds. Here is the Polynesian Power Trip, the Samoan Stallion Ati Valu and Kai Mana. Introducing first. From Region 1, weighing in at 150 pounds, he is one half of the AZW Tag Team Champions, Bobby the Lightning Bolt! From a Twinkle Town, USA, weighing in at 140 pounds, he is one half of the AZW Tag Team Champion, a one-man musical, Rapard Rocco Shinoda!
It's a thing of beauty, ain't it, folks? The one-man musical, Rockhard Rocco Shinoda, defending their AZW tag team titles on the line, and it is a tough task ahead as they take on the former AZW tag team champions, the PPT, in Antivalu and Kaimana.
Gotta say, like, this team that was brought together by the fans in Waianae, I mean, they've held up, I mean, they are still the tag team champions, and they're putting on the line against arguably the best team in Hawaii, whether you like them or not, and most people don't like them, unless they're related.
And certainly there have been a lot of tag team champions, but no one appreciates and no one values the titles more than this tag team of Bolt and Shinoda.
But you gotta say, like, PPT, man, they're almost to the point where they're obsessed with it. They need it back. They want it back. They almost feel, like, incomplete without it.
And off we go. Here at New Year's Bash, along with DDB, Felipe Ojastro, AZW tag team titles are on the line, one fall to a finish, and this will be the third matchup in the last 3 months between these two teams. The PPT looking to make it the third time's a charm, as they've lost the previous two meetings, lost the titles at Anything Goes over in Waianae, then had their shot in a four-way tag team elimination match with you yourself, DDB, down to the final two teams, and they couldn't take on the gold then.
Yeah, I was so heartbroken when I tripped Kenjiro and cost us the match.
Oh man, vicious shots. And you look at the 260 pound Samoan Stallion. Antivalu with a vicious knife edge chop and just toying with a guy who's only a buck 40 and about 5'5 in Rocco Rockshinoda. Rocco Shinoda, excuse me. And Rocco gonna try and mount some offense here. And that's how you do it. You gotta take the big man down.
Oh yeah. Oh. Wow.
From his knees.
Walloping, I mean, clothesline. And Rocco, 3 minutes into this match, he may be out.
Yeah, talk about size differential.
Like a rag doll, scooping a slam.
And he came, like, imagine, Antivalu's, what, about 7'8" right now? And that's without the lifts.
Oh, man. Put right into the corner.
Oh, putting some torque in that low back.
And a power slam. Gonna end it right here. Gets a two count and a blatant choke now on Antivalu. And I'll get Antivalu now. Playing to the crowd. I'll tell you what, this is a team with a lot of fight, a lot of heart, a lot of desire. I tell you what, Rocco's got to do anything that he can to try and get into the corner. And a couple shots, one to the lower back, one to the chest. Big leg drop, and here comes Kaimana.
Setting them off here, double team. And they're a tag team. They've been a tag team for a long time. They've held that titles twice, including in one reign that lasted over a year.
Trying to capture their third reign as AZW Tag Team Champions. And, you know, the Polynesian Power Trip voted by you, the fans, as the AZW Tag Team of the Year in 2010. Great spine buster and a float over. Here's the cover. And still not going to put away Shinoda.
And it's good to see Kaimana is not inebriated tonight. I mean, we saw what happened last time. Came a little under the weather, three sheets to the wind. And Rocco knocked him out cold.
Still, we have yet to see anything coming up. Great hanging backbreaker. I'll tell you what, Rock Hard has taken a lot of punishment here in the early going.